Yeah, hope you are observing the slide over here now. Yes. Yes. Is my screen is visible? Yes, any one of you respond? Sanat, Shiva, Vishwanath, Rishikesh. Any one of you please respond. Is my screen is visible to you? Okay. Visible, no? Visible, right. At least any one of you please respond. Vishal, thank you. Right. So here direct measurement means we are going to take the instrument such a manner that whatever the liquid we are going to pour within that, by that means we are going to get the how much quantity of liquid level is existing with us. Okay. So here this particular direct measurement part, we are going to say what is the quantity of the liquid, or in terms of milliliters, we can read that particular quantity of that particular liquid. So the way in which we are going to get these measurements directly by reading it, we are going to say that measurement method as a direct measurement method. So even with the help of scale, vernier calipers, micrometer, whatever the dimensions you are going to say, those are direct measurements only. Because by keeping the object in between the surfaces, flat surfaces, we are going to get the readings over there. Next, indirect measurement. Suppose say we are having a tree which is where the height of that particular tree is not known for us, but nearer to that one we are having a child where her length is, or height is around 4 feet 10 inches. Okay, and as an observer you are observing from one of the end means, at that moment for you the tree is around 125 feet, right? And here from the observer to the lady or the girl, whoever is standing over there, it is 5.5 feet. Okay, so at that moment it is possible for us to find out the length, the height of the that particular tree whichever is existing over there. So how it is possible means, here we are going to utilize the trigonometric principles. By means of the trigonometric principles, whatever the measurements we are having, known measurements, from that we are going to find out the x feet or something, y feet of the given tree over there. So here this method is considered as an indirect measurement. That means directly, if a measurement is not possible to measure with the existing conditions over there, at that moment from the known conditions or from the known heights, we are going to measure the height of that particular unknown value. So at that moment we will say that approaching method, whichever is there, it is a indirect measurement of measurements, or simply we can call it as an indirect measurement. So like this here, in the first case, we directly by pouring the liquid we can find out what is the level of the what is the quantity of that particular liquid. Similarly here, by seeing we cannot observe, but by comparing the values with the known values over here, we can find out the height of the tree over here. So which is considered as an indirect measurement. Next we are having fundamental measurement. Fundamentally the measurements which are going to be happen, like suppose say a land is having a length of 100 yards or 50 yards. At that moment, standard add distance we are having in terms of a object. So consider a add bar is existing. So that with that you can measure easily what is the measurement of that particular land. Okay, so even some inches are existing, the inch scale you can find out what is the measurement of at that particular location where we want to find out the length or width. Like this, we are having some more fundamental measuring instruments. With that, we can easily identify what is the quantity or how much quantity we require. According to that quantity, we can find out the measurement about it. So that's how we are going to say it as a fundamental measurement. So that means here standard quantity instruments are going to be existing. With that, we can find out the measurement, which is a fundamental measurement. Then we are having a comparison measurement. So sometimes unknown value of the object whichever is there with the known value, we are going to make the comparison. Suppose if it is getting less, means we will add some more weights. By that, ultimately by comparison, the whatever the unknown object value is there, that can be found out, which is done by means of a comparison measurement. Okay, so these are the some of the methods which we are approaching to know the unknown values. Null method measurement. Suppose say one side we are having unknown weight, and that unknown weight whichever is there, by replacing the with the known value, suppose say 100 gram or 200 gram, 300 gram, with that weight, if this value of the unknown object is known for us, then that will consider as a null measurement. That means here we are going to weigh the both the things, and wherever the both weighings are going to give us the same measurement, that will be considered as a null method measurement. That means from the zero level to original value level, we are going to get the different kinds of existing weights over there. By that, we will measure it. So that means here, by making the nullifying of these particular two values, we are going to get the measurement, means that will be considered as a null method measurement. And a deflection measurement. So sometimes, suppose say in your hometown, suppose if you are having a field, a paddy field, suppose whenever the growth, the yield of that, what you call, that yield of that particular paddy is there for us, means we are going to cut it, and we are going to make the shifting of that particular paddy to the nearby market. At that moment, we will make the measurement of that paddy which is available within the gunny bags. So at that moment, with the help of some of the deflection measurement, we are going to see how much weight of that particular bag is there, paddy bag. So at that moment, within that, what is there? First of all, we are going to attach that particular object or that particular bag, whichever is there, to a spring attached hook, whichever is there, that spring attached hook, we are going to join it, or we are going to make the attachment of that our gunny bag with the hook. So by means of that, what will happen? Due to the existing weight over there, there will be a deflection in the spring, and accordingly the deflection in the spring which will make the movement of the pointer from low level to the high level. Suppose initially if it is having 0 kg, means whenever it is the spring, due to the spring action, due to the hook which is attached with the paddy bag, at that moment, depending upon the weight over there, the pointer will move around 20 kg to 30 kg, 30 kg to 40 kg, 50 kg, something like that. So here, the deflection by means of that spring movement, and by means of the deflection of the pointer, we are going to get the measurement. So that's why at that moment, the method of approach by which we are going to get the measurement part is considered as a deflection measurement. So here, generally we are going to observe whenever the measuring instrument whichever is there, which is attached with the spring and pointer actions. Next, contact measurements. So this is also one kind of method where our object is contacted with the instrument. Suppose say here vernier calipers is it's jars whichever are there. One is movable jar and another one is a fixed jar. This fixed and movable jar, they are having a flat surfaces over here, and object is kept within the jars. So by means of this, what is happening? Due to the contact of the surfaces, or due to the contact of these flat surfaces of the jars, the object dimension is going to be verified or checked. So at that moment here, the measurement part, whichever is there, it is done by means of contacting the measurement or contacting the instrument. We are going to see the distance of this particular object or weight, sometimes the diameter. So all these parameters whichever are there, it is done by means of contacting the measuring instrument we are going to get. So in that particular condition, we have to say that is a method which we followed, a contact kind of measurement. So that means here, object whichever is there, that is, that should be contacted with the instrument, then only there is a possibility of getting. So there are some more kind of measurement techniques which we are having contactless also. Suppose say a circular disc is there where it is attached to the rotating shaft over here. So in one direction, if it is rotating, at that moment, in order to measure the speed of this disc, we have kept a reflective strip, right? So that reflective strip, whenever it is rotated in clockwise direction or anti-clockwise direction, continuously the strip will arrive at one particular location. So at that particular location, if you keep the tachometer, within this, whatever the infrared transmitter and receiver is there, with that, there will be light passage onto the disc, and there will be a deflection of the light we are going to see. So in the tachometer, we are having a existence of a device such that when it will emit the light and it will receive the light. So by means of this, what will happen here, the whatever the speed of the disc is there, that will be known for us. So like this here, contactless measurements whichever are there, they are going to give without contacting the that particular device, the values are going to be measured. So in that concern, we will say the method of approach which we are doing, that is a contactless measurement method. So like this here, so far we observed direct, indirect, then deflection type, and some of the time null method type, and in some of the cases we observed contactless and contact measurements. So like this, overall the methods which we are approached to get the proper measurement, we are going to utilize some of these methods only. So all the instruments whichever are segregated or manufactured, those comes under all these particular measuring techniques or measuring methods only. Okay. Once the ideology about that methods which we got means, then classification of measuring instruments. Suppose say within our metrological part or metrological subject point of view, what are the instruments we are having? Okay, so here if you make the instrument list depending upon the utilization, there will be length measuring devices and angle measuring devices, deviation checking, and surface finish. So in the metrological instrument part, basically we are looking these kind of instruments which are comes under length measuring, angle measuring, deviation checking. That is, instead of original value, if the value is deviated at that moment, how to check it. And finally, surface finish. So by means of surface finishing, whatever the values we are going to get, that also it is going to be sensed by means of some of the metrological instruments. So under length measuring part, within this we are going to utilize length measuring devices as well as supporting devices also. So as far as length measurement devices are considered, we are having digital kind of length measuring techniques and some manual kind of length measurement. Okay, so suppose a length measurement, suppose a given object's length, if you want to find out, means generally we are using with a vernier caliper, we are measuring it. So that vernier caliper existing means, within that, by means of optical kind of vernier caliper is going to existing. Sometimes a mechanical kind of mechanical measurement vernier caliper is going to existing. So here, depending upon the availability, depending upon the cost which we can bear, depending upon those particular conditions, there will be digital kind of vernier calipers, and there are some mechanical kind of vernier calipers are existing. Coming to the angle measuring part, we are having mechanical and optical. So again, after length measurement, sometimes we are going with the angle measurement also. In that particular angle measurement part, we are going with the mechanical measuring instrument and sometimes with the optical one. Okay, so here this optical one, mechanical one, whichever are there. Under mechanical instrument part, whenever we are concentrating on the angle measurement, we are going with the bevel protractor and sine bar. Okay, and in some of the cases, we are going with the toolmaker microscope. So toolmaker microscope is a one kind of optical kind of measuring instrument which will give us angles of a screw thread. So like this, mechanical and optical kind of instruments are existing. Suppose deviation checking. So small deviations, small measuring errors are existing, means those can be detected by means of comparators and gauges. So comparators, they will compare the values, and by that you will get which is the original one and which is a deviated one. Suppose say on a shaft you require a 12 dia, okay, so 12 mm dia you require, but due to the machining operation, some kind of deviation you are getting. Suppose say 12.02 mm, 12.03 mm you are going to get. So by means of that, what will happen, there is a some kind of deviation in the measurement. So instead of 12 mm, you are going to get 12.02, 12.03. So that small deviation, whichever is there, it is going to be sensed by means of comparators. And sometimes it is done by means of gauges also. Okay. And finally, surface finish is one of a parameter. Surface finishing, whether it is done properly or not, to check it, we are having a metrological instrument called TallySurf. With that, we can find out what is the roughness of that particular surface, where the flatness is required. Instead of that flatness, if it is undergoing any irregularities like waviness, roughness, if it is existing, that roughness value we can find out. So like this, overall, if you see in the metrological instrument part, as I told you, metrology is the science which deals with the measurements. So wherever measurements are there the measurements are included with the instruments. So with that intention, if you go through the metrological instruments within our laboratory point of view, even with the subject point of view, we have to learn what are the length measuring units, length measuring instruments, angle measuring instruments, deviation checking instruments, and surface finish instruments. So that's why whenever we observe the contents of our syllabus, they are segregated under length measuring part, angle measuring part, deviation checking part, and surface finish part. Other than this, no measurement is going to existing other than these particular instruments. So that's why we are going to make the classification of these measuring instruments as like this. So here, these are the some of the inputs which we are going to consider as an introductory part of the metrological subject. So within this, so far if you observe, we have concentrated different kinds of instruments, different techniques, errors, all those things. Okay, so here, in order to summarize all these things, we will go with the video which is going to give us the same kind of information. So before going to have that video, just wait for a few minutes. I will share that video for you. So this is a video which is shared by means of Indian Institute of Technology Madras. So here this lecture, whatever is going to be taught over here, it is going to give us similar kind of information. Just have a glance on this, because in the introductory part, whatever the content we learned so far regarding this, we are having this particular lecture. So that's why here, once all of you consider this particular video. So here, this particular lecture is delivered by means of K. Sadashivappa, who is one of the professor within the Industrial Production Engineering, Bapuji Institute of Engineering and Technology. But this particular video is shared by means of IIT Madras. Okay. Let us see what he is going to give us that particular things.
Hello everybody and welcome to this course on metrology. Before I formally start telling you about metrology, I would like to introduce myself. I am Sadashivappa, working as professor in Bapuji Institute of Engineering and Technology, Davanagere. Metrology is the science of measurement, which mainly deals with measurement of size, form, and positions. In general, for any kind of quantity to be measured, there must be a unit of measurement, and it should be possible to express the quantity in numbers. Hence, metrology is concerned with the establishment of units of measurements and their standards. It is concerned with establishing methods of measurement, and it also deals with different kinds of measuring instruments. In a broader sense, it is concerned with industrial inspection. It deals with inspection of raw materials to inspection of finished components with the help of standard measuring tools and gauges. Metrology is used in many areas such as machine tool building, automobile engineering, biomedical engineering, space applications, building science, marine science, and many other scientific and engineering fields. In the present course, we will be mainly dealing with the dimensional metrology, wherein we will be learning about precise measurement of lengths, angles, forms, and positions. This course is spread across 44 lectures arranged in 12 modules. We will be learning about basic definitions and terminologies related to metrology, different measurement standards, units, methods of measurements, errors in measurements, and calibration aspects in module number 1, that is introduction to metrology. And in module number 2, we will be dealing with usage of different measuring instruments such as vernier caliper, micrometer, angle measuring devices. In module 3, we will be discussing about limits, fits, and tolerances. What is the need of tolerance? What are the different kinds of fits available? How to select a proper fit for a given application? Such things we will be discussing in module number 3. And in module number 4, we will discuss about the measurement of geometrical features. Mainly, we will be discussing about straightness measurement and squareness measurement. And then we will move on to measurement of surface finish and screw thread element measurements, gear element measurements, tapered measurement, and radius measurement. And in module number 9, we will be discussing about use of interferometry for measurement of flux.
So here, after the introduction part, we are going to discuss about interferometry only.
Flatness of precise surfaces will.
Here, this particular video is going to give us a glance, whatever the points we discussed so far. The glances are that particular important points which are there. Those information you can get from this video.
We're discussing about construction and application of different force microscopy.
In a shift, drug delivery to a patient, measuring blood pressure, body weight, body temperature, etc. In all these activities, we are trying to measure a physical quantity like pressure, volume, length, etc. Now, let us take a simple example of buying things like cloth, and let us understand the measurement process in detail. When we go to a cloth shop and ask for a certain length of material, immediately the shopkeeper will take the material and he will take a measuring tape and he measures the cloth of the required length and cuts it and gives it. Now, in this process, we can understand that in the process of measurement, a physical quantity is required for which we had to give the value, and then we require a standard or a reference for measurement process. And then there is a comparison process. That means the shopkeeper will open the cloth, he will spread the cloth on a table, and then the length of the cloth that is to be cut is the physical quantity. And then the shopkeeper takes the measuring tape, and this is the reference for us to measure the length. And then he compares the cloth length with the measuring tape. This is the process of comparison. That means in any measurement process, we have three entities. First one is the physical quantity, in our example length, and then a reference for measurement, that is measuring scale, and then process of comparison, that means comparing length of cloth with the measuring tape. So that is the third entity. Now, let us look at this simple picture and try to understand the measurement process in detail. So we have the datum on which the measurement process takes place, and then we have workpiece. Okay, the length of the workpiece is to be measured, and then we have a butt plate against which the workpiece is pressed, and then we need a reference, for example a steel rule or a measuring tape. And again, the steel rule is placed on the workpiece and it is pressed against the butt plate. Now, we start measuring the length of the workpiece from this point, from this edge of the workpiece. So, this is the reference point. And then we look for the coinciding division on the steel rule, which division on the steel rule is coinciding with the other edge. So, this becomes the measurement point. The difference between the reference point and the measurement point is the length of the workpiece, that is the physical quantity that is to be measured. If the measurement process is very simple, like measuring the length of a workpiece or a diameter of workpiece, using a micrometer we can do that. We can just hold micrometer in our hand and we can take the workpiece in our other hand, and then we can measure. So, in this case, datum is not required. So, in some cases datum will be required, in some cases datum will not be required. Now, let us try to understand the importance of measurement process. So, I gave some examples of our daily activities wherein measurement is carried out in all activities. That means measurement is everywhere and it is playing a vital role in our lives. Now, measurement is very essential to ensure safety and effectiveness of healthcare diagnosis and treatment. We measure many parameters when we go to a hospital, like blood pressure measurement, blood composition measurement, etc., etc. The measurement that is carried out should be accurate and it should be precise, so that proper treatment can be given to the patient. Then when we take the example of manufacturing industry, we measure the composition of material. We look for maybe carbon percentage in steel and other alloying element composition. So if the measurement of these composition is proper, then we can build good products. Then to ensure safe operation of vehicles and machine tools, we measure parameters like speed of the vehicle or machine tool, what is the feed rate of various slides of the machine tool, what is the vibration level of machine tools or vehicle, whether the machine tools and vehicles are under safe condition, safe running condition. So to ensure that, measurement is very, very essential. Also to ensure proper food supply, whether any dangerous substances are included in the food supply, to ensure that, we need to measure the food that is supplied. Then to ensure consistency of time standards, so that we can have comfortable communication between two different places or two different countries. To ensure fairness between buyer and seller, measurement is very important. We gave the example of buying a cloth. The seller takes a measuring tape and he measures and he gives the cloth. Now the buyer also can take another scale and he can cross-check whether the length that is supplied is correct or not. That means both the scales used by buyer and seller should be comparable. That means they should be comparable to some national or international standards, so that there will not be any dispute between buyer and seller. Now to evaluate newly developed products and processes, we need to conduct measurement. After the completion of the assembly, we have to check what is the performance level with respect to the cutting parameters or the vibration level, etc., or the health of the machine tool. So we need to conduct many kinds of measurement.
Yes, so we are having less than 1 minute time. At any point of time, our meeting is going to be disconnected. You please rejoin once again if it is disconnected.
To get accurate and precise data in scientific research, we should have measurement process. Now, let us move to understand the definition of the metrology. It is the science of measurement, and there are national metrology institutes around the world to make sure that the measurement we use are.
So here, as I told you, the metrology, it is a science which deals with the measurements only. Okay, so here above the is while